Throw out the waste while you are brandy sugar. Whether you have diabetes or pre-diabetes or just generally suffer effects from brandy sugar swings, you want to know what really works to control your brandy sugar levels. Here are a dozen tips that will help your brandy sugar and your overall health. If you have diabetes, remember you should always work with your health care team first to help control your brandy sugar. One way of controlling or lowering your brandy sugar, work it out. In the morning you wake up, or in the evening you come out and you walk. Walk it out. Walking is a great way to lower your brandy sugar levels and keep them stable. Take the stairs, run errands on foot if possible, and go to that weekend bike ride. It will help you to lower your blood sugar. Even taking a few minutes break to walk each day can hand up. Aim for 150 minutes of moderate intensity exercise per week. Eat more barley. Barley is a whole grain packed with the fiber that taps down your appetite and can help decrease your blood sugar. Why? Your gut bacteria interact with the body, which may in turn help your body metabolize glucose sugar. So don't be afraid to toss barley into soups, on roasted veggies, salad, or have it as a side with the face of chicken. Bump up your exercise. Bump up your exercise intensity. Exercise is a great way to boost your body's ability to manage blood sugar, but making sure it is a heart pumping workout which will help even more. So in that case, you are supposed to combine your macronutrients. Carbohydrate plus protein or fat is a super combination when it comes to controlling brand sugar. So the protein or fat you eat slows down digestion, thus bumpering a brand sugar spike. For some people, a surprise in brand sugar after eating carbohydrates alone could be followed by a drop in sugar in eating bland glucose, which may cause them to feel angry. So when you want to lower your bland sugar, go for the whole fruit of a juice. A glass of orange juice is not the same as eating a whole orange. People generally drink more juice and therefore consume more calories and sugar than they would by just eating a fruit. Plus you get more fiber from the whole fruit. Walk after meals will help also lower your blood sugar. Walking after meals, especially in dinner. When you are done with the dinner, but the disease can wait. The disease can wait. It is time to go for a stroll. Then walk it off strategy is especially helpful after eating carbohydrate heavy meals, particularly in dinner. Other research has found staying active improves insulin sensitivity and helps your cells remove glucose from your bloodstream. So How do you remove glucose from your bloodstream? Get those walking shoes ready. It is only 10 minutes. If the weather isn't cooperating, walk in place in front of the TV. Or stay active indoors by streaming a workout class. This is also possible. Just do some exercise, walk out in the table room. Pick benches wisely also, if you are to keep your blood pressure low. You know vegetables are good for you, but they are not all equal when it comes to carbohydrates. Have a cup of starchy vegetables like peas, corn, or squash equals to 15 grams of carbohydrates. Everything in moderation is fine, but make your most of the time choices that non-starchy variety like lettuce, cauliflower, spinach, carrots, and Brussels sprouts are the best for you to eat if you have to lower your blood sugar. Get enough vitamin D also. Here is another reason to ask your doctor to check your vitamin D levels. Why? Because it could help you decrease your risk of diabetes. So, if you are deficient, supplementing with vitamin D and calcium can help stabilize blood sugar levels. Also, drink more water if you are to lower blood sugar levels. Yes, you sip water. Sipping water can affect your blood sugar. Make the important point. But the important point is avoiding dehydration. When you are dehydrated, sugars in the blood are more concentrated, and thus your blood glucose levels are higher. But you don't need to take a ton of water. You should generally drink water when you are thirsty, whether you have a blood sugar problems or not. The other one is snack on nuts. Nuts are very good for eating between meals or even after meals. They are one super portable food that you can pop in your mouth without worrying. Without worrying that they are doing something funky to your blood sugar. When eaten alone or with meals, nuts help keep blood sugar levels because they are packed with healthy fats and few carbohydrates. Eat more mindfully. What does that mean? You must mind on what you eat every time, every moment. Indeed, eating lunch in front of your computer or having dinner or watching TV at night and make it a goal to eat more mindfully. This practice means that you pay attention to anger and fullness cues. Stay present when you are eating and assess the emotional component of food. Bonus, mindful eating can also help you deal with food cravings and prevent eating anyhow. Two things that can spur weight gain and also bring the sugar levels. Think long term for your health. There isn't a magic diet. There isn't a magic diet